Hello everyone, welcome to this new episode of Watch That Catitude with me, Sairish, your friendly cat behaviorist. Today we will talk about 5 common things that cat owners assume or do that they really should not. These things and assumptions really affect your cats badly. So without further ado, let's dive right into it. Number 1, do not assume that cats are independent. While yes, cats are independent and naturally solitary animals, however, it is a very wrong assumption and leads to a lot of problems. This stems the idea that if you are working full-time and are not home most of the day, you can still get a cat because cats are very low maintenance and they can still entertain themselves and will be perfectly fine. I'm very much opposed to this idea. If you're going to leave your cat alone for all of the day without it having things to do, this is a very unhappy life for the cat. Our pet cats most of the time need our love, affection, and our assistance in understanding what they need to do and how they can make their lives happy. We have to guide them and be there for them most of the time, if not all. That brings me to the second thing. Do not leave your cat just be. You can't just get a new cat and let it do whatever it wants and not guide it. This will lead to problems for you as well as for your cat. Your cat is in a new environment and it does not know how to cope with it. You have to tell it what to do and what not to do and give it a proper routine, which I emphasize on again and again in several videos. Giving your cat a routine makes them understand how to make most of their life, and it also helps us coexist with our cats more peacefully and happily. I have a separate video on that, the link of which I'm going to pop up here and down here, which I do advise you watch. Again, I must insist, if you are not going to be house most of the day, most of the time, then you need to leave your cat with things to do when you're gone and things to look forward to. They're not just sleeping all day or getting up to some kind of mischief. If you're not going to do that, then you'll have a cat who would either sleep all day, become a beast, and would be opposed to doing any kind of activity, which is also an unhealthy life. And or it will start misbehaving while you're away, breaking things, climbing on things, scratching things, to get that frustration out. Out in the wild, cats are very active and they hunt throughout the day and they need that kind of mental stimulation. While this is a common knowledge amongst dogs that they need to go out on walk and have the mental stimulation, it is unfortunately not very common with cats. Cat owners do not realize that the cats also need that kind of activity as on daily basis and not just occasionally on weekends. Now to the third point. I oppose free feeding. I know many people do free feeding in their house, which means leaving dry kibble out for their cats throughout the day to graze, which I understand works perfectly fine for many people, but most of the time it leads to cats becoming obese, which leads to further issues. Out in the wild, cats hunt throughout the day and they are also known as naturally opportunist eaters. Which means that they will eat when the prey is available, because they can go on days and hours without having to having caught anything in the wild to eat. But if they can catch more, or if they find a place where they have a lot of food, they will try to eat as much as they can at that time. Opportunist hunting leads to the behavior where cats, when they find free feed all day long, they eat more than what is required. Also, do not forget that dry kibble is a lot more fattening than wet food. You can give dry kibble along with fat food, but just giving dry kibble or free feeding them all the time might lead to a lot of problems. It's great if it works for you and your cat, but most of the time for others it doesn't. If you are out most of the day, then you can always buy automatic feeders that come with ice as well. So you can even put wet food in it and schedule these meal times even when you're away. So your cat will look forward to this time a lot. Number 4, do not shout or manhandle your cat. Trust me, I know sometimes our cats can really push us to the edge, whether it is scratching your brand new sofa or waking you up in the middle of the night or just meowing for attention. I understand that sometimes we can lose our temper. However, I must insist that please try not to shout at your cat, because it only makes them scared of you and it doesn't help them understand why they're being shouted at. So it won't get rid of the behavior, but it will bring trouble between you and your cat's relationship. And this brings to our last and fifth point, very closely related to the fourth one. Do not do a negative training with your cat. Shouting is also a form of negative training. I decided to make this video. Recently, I came across a post in one of the cat groups on Facebook, which I will just quote was, "My cat is waking me up every morning at 3 to 4 a.m., creating a havoc in the house, scratching walls and mewing. Up till now, squirting him with water gun helped with the bad behavior. However, it doesn't affect him anymore. I have also tried to chase him down, grab him and pin him down until he relaxes. It only works for a moment, but now he's also becoming aggressive. I've told him no and closed the door on him, but he doesn't listen. He's getting worse by day." I can't tell you how much uncomfortable and sad this post made me. This poor cat has been squirted water on his face all his life. He has been chased down, he has been pinned down forcefully to relax. He's being expected to show some kind of positive behavior while everything around him is a chaos. This poor cat is visibly having a lot of mental stress, and this kind of mental stress will lead to a lot of other bad behaviors, as well as a lot of medical issues such as cystitis. It really breaks your cat's spirit. What even is bad behavior of a cat? It is what our understanding of a behavior is. For cats, scratching things, climbing on things, waking up early at night are only the natural things that a cat should do. Now we can understand and do a compromise and try to lovingly teach our cats to meet us midway, or we can shout at them and forcefully try to make them humans. If you want a cat that does not exhibit its natural behaviors, then maybe you do not understand a cat or really want to be with a cat. That's why it's always of vital importance that you understand your cat's behavior before trying to give them a proper place to exhibit their natural behavior. For instance, if they're scratching, then you can give them proper places to scratch as well as climb. You can also give them toys so they can keep themselves busy. You can also give them activity feeders to have, they have mental stimulation, so they're not going out of their mind of boredom, as well as a lot of love and affection. If they're keeping you up at night, you need to teach them the routine that you have rather than forcing it upon them. I hope you found this video informative and it will help you understand your cat a little better. If you did, please like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.
Thank you.